Hey folks, before we get started, my open casting call for a 13th Doctor audio fan production is still underway. You have 1 week left to audition. You can find more info in the description below. This video was made possible through the support of my patrons. Hello ladies and gentlemen, my name is Mr. TARDIS and welcome to Big Finish Fridays! Last week, Big Finish treated us to an adventure in the style of the Arabian Nights with the Fifth Doctor and Nyssa, and this week, we go even further, even deeper, into the Doctor Who universe with Stolen Goods, the first episode in the first box set for Jenny, the Doctor's Daughter. Now, Jenny was introduced in the 2008 episode, The Doctor's Daughter. The episode isn't very good. However, the way the episode ends, with Jenny coming back from the dead with regeneration energy and escaping Messaline by stealing a spaceship, has left fans curious as to whether or not the program would follow up on this loose end. And they haven't. So after 10 years and 1 month after that episode's broadcast, Big Finish thought, if you want something done, just do it yourself, and they released a set with Georgia Moffat reprising her role as Jenny. As usual, I've chosen this release as it's Big Finish's free download this week during lockdown, and I've put a link to Stolen Goods in the description below where you can download it for free, at least at time of writing and recording, and you can also download the full anthology which is on sale now. We'll be delving into spoilers in this review, so be sure to download Stolen Goods first, though to be fair, there's not actually that much to spoil. Stolen Goods is definitely a setup pilot episode, as it introduces the regular supporting cast and sets them up on their new adventures, but let me back up. Stolen Goods takes place immediately after the events of The Doctor's Daughter, with Jenny struggling to control her new spaceship and literally crashing into Garundel, a fast-talking con man running an extortion con with his colleague Vesh, and I loved this guy. He's voiced by Stuart Milligan, and I loved this almost cartoony character in what often tries to be a grounded universe. Even without the frog, salamander, whatever design on the cover art of this box set, I can just imagine this guy when hearing him talk.
Sounds like you've got some hairline lattice fractures. Looks like we're both in pretty bad shape.
It doesn't look very damaged.
It's all on the inside. You're an expert on these Nova-class drives?
Well, this is my first...
Didn't think so. Oh, they look pretty, but they can't take the impact like the old Black Star Flyers.
Right.
Tell you what, Blondie, I can...
Actually, the name's Jenny.
Whatever. I got a pal not far from here. Vesh Teralesh owns a space yard less than 5,000 clicks that away. Well, she likes to call it an emporium. You know her?
No, I'm new in these parts. Well, most parts, actually.
However, when doing some quick research for this review, it turns out that Garundel has already appeared in the Big Finish universe. He's already had a couple of encounters with the Seventh Doctor, but you don't need to know any of that for him to be a fun and engaging character here. Yeah, he's obviously a crook. Yeah, he obviously cannot be trusted, but he's fun, and you love to hate him. But unfortunately, one reason he does stand out so prominently is that Jenny isn't that interesting a character. Now, Georgia Moffat plays her well, and if you liked her in The Doctor's Daughter, then I'm sure you'll like her here, but Jenny is just an amalgamation of the fast-talking, tough, born sexy yesterday tropes distilled into what was clearly meant to be a one-off character. Now, Stolen Goods doesn't really have time to make Jenny an interesting character or expand her beyond these tropes, which, to be frank, have grown pretty stale since Buffy the Vampire Slayer debuted over 2 decades ago, because this story needs to set up the new cast and the new status quo. Now, I'm sure the other episodes in this box set, we've got Prisoner of the Ood, Neon Rain, and Zero Space, I'm sure they flesh out her character more, but compare it to, say, for example, Everything Changes, the pilot episode of Torchwood. That episode does a great job at not only setting up the new cast, the new status quo, etc., but establishing Gwen Cooper and who she is as our gateway into this corner of the universe. Jenny, in Stolen Goods, not so much, and it's strange, because while this episode decides to stay firmly by the book and sticks to the tropes for someone like Jenny, they decide to flip the script on the adversary of this series, Colt 5000, played by Sean Phillips, a cyborg bounty hunter who is hunting down the female Time Lord for unknown reasons. A cyborg bounty hunter killing machine isn't exactly an original idea, but casting an 85-year-old woman to play that role, that is pretty cool. That is messing with convention, and that makes Cult 5000 immediately memorable.
Now, if you just untie me and get off my ship, we can both go about our business. Me to my scrap parts emporium, and you to your...
I am not a sales rep for Galactic Glee Whole Foods. That is a disguise.
I gathered that.
I am travelling incognito.
Got that too. And I won't breathe a word to anyone. I don't know who you are or what you want.
I am Colt 5000, sentient cyborg, bounty hunter class, Harbinger Guild. I want the Time Lord.
I'd really rather you hadn't said all that, but I've got a terrible memory. Awful. If you let me go...
I will not be letting you go.
No, no, please!
Our last recurring element to talk about is Noah, who Jenny awakens from suspended animation and becomes, I guess, her companion in this series. However, since Noah has a similar origin to Jenny, he also doesn't know anything about the universe, meaning that you've paired up two characters who were both born sexy yesterday and don't know anything. There's no audience surrogate, and everything needs explaining all of the time. It's a strange decision. Maybe it pans out better later on, but I don't know, maybe future episodes deal with this better, but it's a really odd status quo to establish. Still, Noah reads as an unknown species on one of Garundel's devices, so his origin is a mystery that I am invested in. Also, speaking of which, Garundel is able to use his device to know that Jenny is a Time Lord, and it's always interesting to see how other people regard the Time Lords in this universe.
The Time Lords are gone. You know that. Nothing left. Present company accepted, and thank the stars, because I've always found them to be tricksy little irritants.
As for the actual plot itself, it really is just a case of setting up this new cast, Jenny improvising her way out of a situation, either by inventing something or just fighting her way out of it, then setting something else up, Jenny improvising her way out of that. Honestly, despite Stolen Goods only being an hour long, it felt longer. Now, I didn't dislike Stolen Goods, and there's some potential to expand upon in future episodes like Noah's origin, though Noah as a character isn't very interesting. Garundel is a lot of fun, and I really liked Cult 5000. It just isn't really enough to hook me into a new series of adventures in this universe. Part of me wants to think that Jenny had much more interesting early adventures after escaping from Messaline, so on that metric, on this arbitrary scoring system, I am deeming Jenny, the Doctor's daughter, Stolen Goods, not canon. If you liked Jenny in The Doctor's Daughter, then more power to you. You'll probably like this, but if she didn't do anything for you, The Stolen Goods I don't think will do anything to convert you or change your mind, and maybe that's okay. The theme tune is pretty awesome, though. Thank you so much for joining me this Big Finish Friday. What did you folks think of Stolen Goods? Did you prefer it to me? Did you dislike it more? Please comment and appease that YouTube algorithm, and maybe even give this video a like. You can also support me via Patreon, which is massively appreciated due to these uncertain lockdown times. The names of my supporters are on screen now, and I'd like to give a particular shout out to Andrew Blewett, Anne Neubauer, Callum Baird, Charlotte Pierce Cornish, Dean Jones, Dylan Whittaker, Flabu, Joseph Adams, Katie Maxwell, Luna Day, Matthew Perry, Mitchell Radford, Palex, Paul Warbeck, Raven Woods, Rebecca Hill, Shazeb Mangi, The Brit Sniper, Vibraphonic Marxism, William Jax, Zachary Taylor, aka Mario Fanboy 15, and Zabi 555. Thank you so much for joining me this Friday, and I'll see you folks next time.